I couldn't accept that he was dead. I needed that fucking dossier!
Hey fellas, we finally have our first official information for Call of Duty 2020. Late last night, Activision decided to confirm a few things here and there, as well as talking a lot about the reveal. So, they're talking about it more than actually doing it. But of course, things are kicking off, so if you are not subscribed, please do, and let's get straight into this. Yeah, it's official, Treyarch are back. The fan favorite studio are bringing us another game, alongside Raven Software, so this is the second COD ever, after Modern Warfare 3, to be developed by multiple different studios, which can probably only be a good thing. Probably. Treyarch fanboys, this one is for us. So yeah, they have officially confirmed the game, but they didn't say it's a Black Ops game or they didn't like confirm the title, but hey, we all know where this is heading. Now, Activision went ahead and talked about Warzone and its link to COD 2020. They said it made them rethink how, when, and even where to reveal the next game, so I think that kind of tells us all we need to know. The reveal is going to be a live event which happens in Warzone, like an in-game event. We know that already, but we still to this day don't exactly know what that means, like what's actually going to go down, what's actually going to happen, despite having leaks, despite hearing this for a long time from like leaked information and leaked stuff directly from the game, it's still like, what's actually going to happen? I don't know. They also said the reveal is going to be very different and more engaging. So I think, like, well, yeah, it's going to be different and more engaging. I'm thinking maybe it is going to be like an actual Easter egg, like a cross-map Easter egg where the community has to go across and do things and find things, if you get what I'm saying. I'm pretty sure there will be a regular trailer at some point, but a normal COD reveal is done by a trailer or a live stream, some kind of event like that. But to reveal the game instead, it's going to kind of be like an Easter egg or a zombies quest where, like, us, the community actually needs to participate and go digging and, like, I don't know, finding stuff, piecing together the puzzle. So you never know, it might be in-game right now with stuff in the Season 5 update, but we just need to actually go and do something. Another quote which basically just tells us the same thing is Warzone will be a platform to share franchise news and information. So like if there's something big going on in COD, it's going to be revealed or shared into Warzone. I like the sound of it. I really do love it. Talking about loving it, Activision say they do think the fans are going to absolutely love COD 2020, which, I mean, I don't know, humans do feel hate as a more powerful emotion than love, and this is the COD community, we do love to hate, so, oh no, Activision, I wouldn't be so confident in that. And I think to end it off here, they say people are having fun playing across its campaign mode, as well as online modes, which the developers are very well known for. Well, this is Treyarch we're talking about, so I don't know if anyone, probably, there's probably people out there kind of still wondering or questioning if zombies is going to return, but hey, lads, Treyarch is very well known for zombies, so I don't think zombies returning in a Treyarch game, yeah, I don't think that's something we need to question anymore. And also, talking about Warzone revealing things, I would love, instead of a regular zombies reveal where there's a trailer dropping or a panel with the actors or whatever, instead, if it was like a zombie invasion or apocalypse in Warzone. Damn, that would just, please, can this happen? Maybe like in October for Halloween or so? I don't know, man, I'm just speculating. And also, talking about the developers and testers loving the game behind the scenes, I mean, sure, we'll take that as good news, but at the same time, have they ever come out and said, and testers hate the game, they say this shit sucks, like, no, they say every year that it's good, so, yeah. Propaganda. Anyway, we'll take it as good news. So fellas, stay spicy, and I will see you in the next one. Cheers.